Somewhere between space and time, there is a place, the Archive of Awesome. An ancient vault that guards the most amazing stories and myths. Each book, a magical gateway to the Paperverse. Let me take you on a journey through the seven masterpieces. It's time to return to games.
Is that really you? I'm so happy to see you after all this time. It seems like it's been ages since you left our town. I just wish we weren't meeting under such dire circumstances. Back then, it was peaceful. But now, the town is disturbed by a demonic presence that's spreading throughout the land. Most of our friends are gone. Some people fled. Some took their own lives. Some have just vanished. Those who stayed have lost their minds or are too frightened to leave their houses. I'm doing my best to keep everyone's spirits up. But the truth is, we won't survive for long without help. Just don't tell anybody I said that. You must have lots of questions, but I don't have many answers. Talk to the sage if you want to know more. He might be able to help you.
Your arrival brings hope to my old heart. There's no better way to forge one's skill than by traveling. I should know. But I beg you not to leave. We need you here. Dark things lurk in the depths beneath the old cathedral. I've seen plenty of evils in my travels, but this makes my journey through the dragon wastes look like a walk in the park. Everything started with the disappearance of our bishop. I fear he has been dragged into the catacombs deep below the church. I do not know what caused such desecration of that holy place. That enigma is yet to be solved. And you are the only one who can do it. Just remember to be careful. Few who have ventured into the dark made their way back. And those who did were no longer alive.
I am the sword that splits darkness.
Thank you.
see that the sanctity of this place has been fouled.
Living souls venture into the depths under the cathedral, as this is the realm where the dead rest, or at least should be resting. Countless warriors, men of the cloth, mages, and even kings of old were buried there with troves of gold and gems. But the dead are now restless. Quickened by some unholy powers, they are haunting the corridors like wild animals, and their courage, virtue, and talents have been replaced with mindless violence. Ending their painful existence will be an act of mercy, if you ask me.
I've been busy too while you were away. The fortune teller is teaching me her craft, and I don't mean her skill with guards. It's called prize brewing, and it's the art of producing powerful magical elixirs that someone like you should find useful. All you need to do is collect the ingredients. I'll take care of the rest. Now, this is the magical stuff I'm talking about. So there are some rules. First, the more ingredients I mix, the greater the potion's power will be. Second, you can drink it and enjoy a little magic anytime you want. But the process will get more expensive each time. Third, if monsters slay you in the dungeons, the potion will weaken. It's because I'm making them just for you, so they have to be magically linked to your essence.
Greetings, traveler. People call me the fortune teller. I'm pleased to see there are souls courageous enough to visit a place like this and stay. In truth, I came here recently myself, as I had to leave the royal capital. I am certain you have already heard about me and my excellent skills from the lovely barmaid I'm tutoring. Believe me when I say you will find my craft most useful in your adventures. Feel free to talk to me should you need any assistance. The townsfolk are good, but simple people, and know little about the arcane. That sage may be an exception, but his wit, not to mention his social skills, are clearly dulled by age. We're all lucky that cranky old men tend to be harmless. Cards are my specialty. They represent a novel approach to magic, offering a superior alternative to clunky weaponry and verbose spellcasting. Unfortunately, new things are often frowned upon, even more so in quaint places like this town. Can you imagine not so long ago those people traded with a local blacksmith? This is so Middle Ages. No wonder he went bankrupt. But let's get back to business. Cards are universal magical items which can manifest properties of weapons, spells, and other artifacts. Some consume magical essence once used, but they can be recharged using objects found in the dungeons or with my help at a reasonable price. Just like with playing cards, the trick is to find the right combination of magical properties that gives you the best advantage.
Ready?
open my next inn in a warmer climate. Jungle, maybe.
Thank the heavens for hearing my prayers and sending us a champion of light. I shall aid you in your struggle to the best of my limited abilities. Come to me should you need remedies for ailments of body or soul. Yet you should remember it is no small task to face the legions of evil. You must shield yourself with faith. There is no better protection against darkness. If you allow yourself to falter, you shall become defenseless and even risk losing your immortal soul. I saw what happened to those who went astray in their spiritual vocation and... Oh, no, it's better not to dwell on such things lest darkness overcome us.
Animated cadavers are capable of experiencing only the most base effect, hunger. Who can imagine a less meaningful existence? Their bodies are still decomposing, so it's recommended to keep them at a distance as the gases they produce are of the deadliest kind. Fortunately, they also smell awful, which serves as a warning, just like the stench of charlatanry emanating from a fortune teller's wagon.
Already?
These creatures are made of stone, which makes them extremely resilient to elements. Fire, frost, or poison cannot harm them. Their abilities are fascinating. When harmed, they petrify and lie in slumber for thousands of years, slowly regenerating. All adventurers should be warned that statues may not be what they seem. Some scholars claim that gargoyles carry a trace of demonic blood, like that charlatan woman, although it's much more obvious in her case.
Welcome back, my friend. I'm sure you've already noticed how things have changed for the better around here while you were traveling around the world. Apart from the demonic presence, of course. One as smart as yourself surely realizes that this mostly is due to my beneficial presence in this small town. Take Barmaid as an example. A simple girl, to be sure, but surprisingly talented when it comes to prize brewing. Her potential would surely go to waste if it wasn't for me. Her focus and strong will remind me of myself in youth. Then there's the sage, whose stories are nothing but half-truths. Simple folk are easily swayed by men like him, so I have to correct him all the time. As for the healer, I helped him a lot, and even offered to read his fortune for free, but he ran away. Most curious. Make no mistake, he's hiding something.
Already?
See, your future is very grim.
Thank you.
How we used to play, lying in the grass, watching the clouds and guessing our future from their shapes. We saw many strange things, but I never suspected what fate had in store for us. Running an inn isn't that bad. At least, it wasn't until the dark rituals. Now, everyone's afraid of being eaten by some nasty creature. Some people even ponder suicide. And just look at our garden. We used to grow all sorts of vegetables and herbs, but now the soil is poisoned with dark magic, and demons trample everything with their hooves. Ah, but complaining doesn't make anything better. I still get a lot of help from the sage. He may be cranky at times, but he's always treated me like a daughter. Then there's the fortune teller. She's a fascinating woman, and I'm very lucky to learn from her. And now you're back.
When evil strikes you down in the dungeons, it takes a lot of my effort to deliver your soul from the clutches of darkness. Death always takes its toll, So any equipped cards remain at your grave, and so will grant you no aid until you retrieve them. Also, some ingredients collected in the arcane cauldron perish, as spells and elixir are mere tricks in the light of the divine. Some things cannot be explained, they must be believed. Many scholars devoted their lives of prayer, hoping for illumination and understanding of the nature of the soul, but very few succeeded. In the scriptures, they usually compared spiritual links to threads of yarn being cut and souls to little pots being broken. Then again, holy men are not very skilled when it comes to similes, as their virtue stems from other qualities.
Let's teach it a lesson.
Barmaid is as kind as she is strong, and these two qualities rarely go hand in hand. She's been caring for me as if we were family, and not once has she complained. I've visited dozens of inns, and believe me, such places are to any village what a hearth is to a house. If the innkeeper has a stout heart, none despair, even if the times are dire. That's what she does for this community, if you ask me. Unfortunately, she seems to have befriended that woman, and even learns her craft. That which corrupts everything she touches. So just to be on the safe side, I'm guarding this well.
Thank you.
finally, a challenge and a chance to use my knowledge for the good. These mystical cards aren't used to cheat and get money from the hopeless and naive, so of course the fortune-telling woman knows nothing about them. However, the true scholars of the arcane, like the hermits of the Eastern Wilds, sometimes pass their secrets to those they deem worthy, like myself. You should know that despite their modest look, such objects can hold powerful enchantments with remarkable properties. Still, as long as their wondrous attributes remain unknown, they are completely useless. Consider yourself fortunate, as I will identify them for you.
So you came across a runic card. You're wise to ask me about it. Let me explain. Cards like these have no inherent properties of their own, but professionals like myself can still use them to enhance other cards. Now, this kind of craft requires subtlety and caution. So whenever you find more of these, keep up that resolute attitude of yours and bring them straight to me. Don't bother talking to the sage about them. His methods are as ancient as his jokes.
Ready?
See dead people.
Perhaps you have noticed there seems to be some antipathy between the sage and the fortune teller. You would do well to pay no heed to what they say about each other. Old age brings many burdens that can make one's heart bitter. As for their adventurous tales, I have yet to see any evidence of their deeds. So I'm afraid the passing years might have weakened their minds, which now drift towards the fantastical. Who knows? They might even believe in the things they're describing so vividly. Now that I think of it, their quarrels might be a facade. Years spent in the monastery made me quite observant, so either I'm growing old too, or they might have something more going on.
Several levels up, but I'm way too proud to ask for directions.
Thank you.
Remember how when we were kids, we used to sneak into the cathedral and bother the monks in the scriptorium? Poor guys were completely helpless and couldn't even yell at us until they chased us outside. Those were happier times. But now, with all the evil creatures down there... Remember the smith? People think he left because of the fortune teller. But I know the true story. You see, a monster snatched his wife and son and dragged them into the dungeons. He followed them and found a terrible place. A kitchen, where demons cook human flesh for their master. Can you imagine seeing your loved ones prepared into a stew? Or even worse, black pudding? He managed to come back and tell us all about it, but his mind was unhinged by grief. The next night, he vanished for good.
Yeah.
and listen for a while.
Oh, I can see your future is very grim. See, your future is very grim. Oh, I can see your future is very grim.
You look like you could use a hot broth. Missed me already?
Thank you.
Barmaid is as kind as she is strong, and these two qualities rarely go hand in hand. She's been caring for me as if we were family, and not once has she complained. I've visited dozens of inns, and believe me, such places are to any village what a hearth is to a house. If the innkeeper has a stout heart, none despair, even if the times are dire. That's what she does for this community, if you ask me. Unfortunately, she seems to have befriended that woman, and even learns her craft, that which corrupts everything she touches. So just to be on the safe side, I'm guarding this well.
Thank you. Let's teach it a lesson.
Remember how we used to play, lying in the grass, watching the clouds and guessing our future from their shapes? We saw many strange things, but I never suspected what fate had in store for us. Running an inn isn't that bad. At least, it wasn't until the dark rituals. Now, everyone's afraid of being eaten by some nasty creature. Some people even ponder suicide. And just look at our garden. We used to grow all sorts of vegetables and herbs, but now the soil is poisoned with dark magic, and demons trample everything with their hooves. Ah, but complaining doesn't make anything better. I still get a lot of help from the sage. He may be cranky at times, but he's always treated me like a daughter. And then there's the fortune teller. She's a fascinating woman, and I'm very lucky to learn from her. And now you're back.
Finally, a challenge and a chance to use my knowledge for the good. These mystical cards aren't used to cheat and get money from the hopeless and naive, so of course the fortune-telling woman knows nothing about them. However, the true scholars of the arcane, like the hermits of the Eastern Wilds, sometimes pass their secrets to those they deem worthy, like myself. You should know that despite their modest look, such objects can hold powerful enchantments with remarkable properties. Still, as long as their wondrous attributes remain unknown, they are completely useless. Consider yourself fortunate, as I will identify them for you.
So you came across a runic card. You're wise to ask me about it. Let me explain. Cards like these have no inherent properties of their own, but professionals like myself can still use them to enhance other cards. Now, this kind of craft requires subtlety and caution. So whenever you find more of these, keep up that resolute attitude of yours and bring them straight to me. Don't bother talking to the sage about them. His methods are as ancient as his jokes.
Stay and listen for a while.
Thank you.
returning customer. And a cute one, too.
Listen for a while.
Perhaps you have noticed there seems to be some antipathy between the sage and the fortune teller. You would do well to pay no heed to what they say about each other. Old age brings many burdens that can make one's heart bitter. As for their adventurous tales, I have yet to see any evidence of their deeds, so I'm afraid the passing years might have weakened their minds, which now drift towards the fantastical. Who knows? They might even believe in the things they're describing so vividly. Now that I think of it, their quarrels might be a facade. Years spent in the monastery made me quite observant, so either I'm growing old too, or they might have something more going on.
Returning customer. They always come back. My horoscope predicts a steamy romance. What a coincidence you're here. See, your future is...
my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Thank you.
Remember how when we were kids, we used to sneak into the cathedral and bother the monks in the scriptorium? Poor guys were completely helpless and couldn't even yell at us until they chased us outside. Those were happier times. But now, with all the evil creatures down there... Remember the smith? People think he left because of the fortune teller. But I know the true story. You see, a monster snatched his wife and son and dragged them into the dungeons. He followed them and found a terrible place. A kitchen, where demons cook human flesh for their master. Can you imagine seeing your loved ones prepared into a stew? Or even worse, black pudding? He managed to come back and tell us all about it. But his mind was unhinged by grief. The next night, he vanished for good. missed me already?
Listen for a while.
No, I can see your future is very grim. See, your future is very grim.
Hour.
Take a peek and you'll go mad. Through the hellish kitchen's door, for the master still craves more. Underground, where shines no sun, this cook's work is never done. Among screams he toils with haste, creature of most subtle taste. Cuts and chops both bone and gut, be it sinew, be it fat. Not an ounce of flesh he'll shun. This cook's work is never done.
My ears are deaf to unholy rhymes. Magic. This must be some kind of portal to the lair of whatever rules this dungeon.